I did have a lot of friends who disappeared, who just could not live themselves with, you know, that constant reminder. They look over at me. I was a twig. I lost a lot of weight, and I was wearing this medical device. I didn't look sick, but, you know, just with the medical device itself, and just my different physical appearance was too much for some of my friends to handle. So a lot of them just disappeared of my life. They say, actually, it's a common thing that you might hear in the young adult population, how cancer is kind of like a friend filter. It's you find out who your real friends are throughout the process, because your real friends are the ones who are going to stick by you and will treat you like a normal person, whether you're wearing a medical device or not. So in terms of how it's affected my social life, of course, I couldn't do a lot of the things that I did before. I'm a I'm a black belt in jiu-jitsu, for example. Can't do that anymore. I used to go camping, canoeing, portage trips with a group of friends. Can't do that anymore. So I had to change a lot of the things that I was doing. I had to reorganize my social life accordingly. And then you have with my relationship with my then partner, was very focused around the medical device, because with the medical device, every time your hair would grow a little bit, you'd have to take the electrodes off. So every couple of days, I'd have to take the electrodes off, shave my head, and then put the electrodes back on. But I need assistance with that. I need somebody to do that for me, and that's where my ex-partner was a big part of that. So a lot of our relationship was actually around the medical device and around my cancer diagnosis, which was unfortunate, because it kind of creates this dynamic that is really hard to navigate, especially when you come to the end of actually using the medical device, which I eventually ended up removing, obviously.